Okay, I gotta do some junk removal. So I'll take this van, but it's just a mattress, a bookshelf, and maybe a little couch or something. So I'm just gonna put the stuff in here for now, just so that it's not in there. But I might be able to sell this stuff actually, even though it's cheap. But it's like about $1,500 this liner. Material, but could have some value because a lot of these come like this with nothing in the walls. It decorates it a bit. So we're going to Vancouver actually, so a bit of a drive, but I don't mind taking a vehicle for a little drive. Just haven't drove it really, so. Put these bars on after. They took them off because they modified the wall there. But they wouldn't line up the bolts no more. The handles were actually over here. The handles are here. This bolt's there, I don't know. Just to bring it up for a second and look. So they're gonna help me on the other side. They have someone to help me there, which makes a difference. Sure how where it went. I don't see no, unless like in here in a groove or something. Not really sure. I was thinking of putting a hole there. Just cut this off here. Put one here and just put two holes here somewhere. Like this, and have that over here, right there, like that on top, and two holes on the side here. It's probably just enough room. So, let's see. I'm not sure how far the door goes in, so I'll have to double check that part. If the door goes in too much, it may not work. Oh, that's got weight. Maybe I'll sell this floor liner. Where to put it? Okay, I get a broom and sweep it out, hold on. Okay, so I've got all these little pieces here. They're just little tiny little things. Get maybe a little hook here or something, like a sticky on thing to take the slack. It's first time I used it, so I'm gonna figure out the bugs. So that's the inside there, and then all that lighting, look at that, how bright that's gonna be. Scratching the door, see, that's how they installed it. See, there's a scratch on it. Maybe we can see. Oh yeah, so lots of room in that bar. Bar is not in the way at all. Use a big bolt on the top, so I'll have extra strength, and a couple small bolts into the body part. That'd be probably perfect. I was going to take a big truck, but I was actually, if I had the white van going, I would take the white van because it's simpler, right? But I got to get used to this thing sooner or later. See, that's the factory lights, four. See the difference there? Should make some videos good, right? Nice and bright videos. Gonna make sure if I have everything. I don't think I need a dolly. I like that little dolly there. It's one on the first level anyways, the guy's gonna help. A lot of fingerprints, you think they would clean them. It's all grease and fingerprints. I might just let my dealer know that. Because you know, some of that, like I say, they should be cleaning that. I mean, I paid $34,000 for the install, right? Look at this, major fingerprints and stuff. I'm gonna take a picture of that. It's hard to see on camera, but anyways, so we're heading to Vancouver. A little bit of a drive, but I kind of want to warm this up anyways and get a good run. It's been sitting for most of the time anyways. Still gotta figure a lot of things out, how things work. There's even something here. Oh, it's your jack and all that. It's right there. Would have never knew, see? There's a battery in here, too. There's supposed to be a battery. Yeah, there's a battery there. Gloves in here. Well, I figured one of the mattresses, like a strip, there's a mattress box spring, and the battery's under here. Just trying to figure it out. That's where your fuel tank is here. Okay, let me, I'll try to video what I can. We'll see, but yeah, okay, first job with the van. Okay, so they helped me, so I'll throw the stuff in. Lucky it was on the first level. Would have been easier, but they actually, they're doing construction here. We're just on the ground level. She said sectional is worried because some of them are pretty big. So well, it's gonna get scratches sooner or later. So just trying to organize shelf here. So I actually put my ad on last night. And I thought there's no calls, but don't, there was a call. Called today. She called about 2 hours ago. That's how it works. That's how she works. It was a bit of a drive, but I want to get a good drive with this van. So this mattress almost seems like it's no spring in it. I think it's foam rubber. It's solid foam rubber. That's why it's so heavy. Mattress is in good shape. Klunkenstein home. No springs, I'll feel nothing. Wow, that's excellent. That might be a good mattress. They're downsizing and they're moving. That's a problem, so. Awesome. Okay, well done. $200 with their help. That's great. Okay, keep moving. See how my mirrors fold in? Flick of a switch. All I have to do, no keys, no, not even open the door, no keys, nothing. Put the foot on brake, press the button, press the mirror down, takes it to factory settings, open window. I'm overheated right now with this hot sweater. My 24K shirts are all soiled, okay? First job with the Silver Surfer. Gotta love it. Seatbelt. But it drives like a car. Like it drives like a dream, to be honest. Like incredibly good. That's why I can see expediters driving these things all day long, because it drives like a car. And I guess my buddy, Big Country Scrapper, got a Sprinter, similar but bigger. He's probably noticing he'll probably never want to drive his truck anymore, because those vans are the best. Nothing falls out, nothing is covered, no one sees your business. Okay guys, we'll keep moving. We got some junk here on the road. No kids' bikes. Nice and heavy. Add up for weight. I didn't empty my vehicle because I had that garbage pickup or junk removal. Steering wheel to turn, there it is. We have to throw chairs first. So we get that bin. Well, this is kind of, yeah, it's not really HMS. Kind of bulky, but if it was wrought iron, I can throw it in a bin. Bin's coming. Okay. There it is. Best I can do. Toy might have battery in there. Edge of the curb almost. Well, I never tumbled, but shoes, cause they got good grips. I got steel toe shoes. I wear them all the time. It's probably got a battery in there, but I can unscrew it, I can look at it. So. I don't have any tools. That's okay. Not that good. What's going on here? Brand new blade, not cutting wood to crap. This might be a waste of time. I can't find my little cutter. That's the biggest problem. Thought I could put some in here. Cut down on the weight a bit. I don't know what it weighs, that's a problem. If it weighs a ton, it's okay. But if it weighs more, that cuts into my profits, right? So I'm not sure where it went. I usually stick it on top there. I don't see nothing here. Well, it's right here. Okay, good. I thought maybe I can try to save a buck or two, you know. I could dump four if I want, four or five. I got two at home. I could take probably 500 pounds off the stuff here easy, off the weight, right? Therapeutic, right? Therapeutic. That's why the guy didn't dump his, he paid to dump it instead. Better than cutting it all up by hand. That's why I took all the big stuff for him, left him just a little bit of rubble at the end. He was happy. It doesn't take enough for some dumpsters, you know. Some of the things not cutting that great. Plus, this stuff smells nice too. And they smell. Knock off a little bit of weight. It's money saved, right? Labor's my labor's labor, right? It's just when I gotta pay dumping, I'm trying to save. All these places, surcharges for everything. So those are surcharges. So like this stuff is a little heavier. Most of it's just little branches. Well, he just cleaned up his yard a bit, trimmed it a bit. He didn't cut big stumps out. My goal is maybe 500 pounds. If I get down to $100 dumping, it won't be that bad. What do you think, Naz Atlas from YouTube? Would you do this kind of crap? I guess you want to save what you can, right? I mean, if it was like $50 a ton or something, they're just gonna grind it up anyways and mix it with soil. But just like some places want $145 a ton. So, and if I go to dump it in my yard, I normally go to, they're gonna charge me $220 a ton. They don't care about green waste. So. The problem. Trying to save what we can, right? I save a little bit, then pass it on to the person too, right? Who pays less. And then eventually they'll call you again, right? There's always, they'll recommend you or something, right? All I did is I just stomped on this thing. So it's not like cut down small, it's all big sizes pretty well. You cut a few pieces, just they were a little too long. Might be boring entertainment, but hey, it's gotta be done. You know, when you do new businesses, right, it's hard to get work because right now the economy's really tight. So you might have to do stuff like this just to get a job, right? You know, the big companies, they advertise big, so they always got clientele, but when you start out, it's tough to get business. You gotta be cheap. You know, you don't want to dump in an alley anywhere. You want to basically try to save some money, right? Most guys drive up and yell and dump it somewhere, but no, I want proper disposal, so if I could save a few dollars, all helps. Right? Like this stuff is, most of it's just not so much like this, but it is, but near the end he just threw a bunch of this different kind of tree, that's why. I think it's like a maple or something. Some dump sites don't want prickle bushes either. Blackberry bushes. So maybe because they don't want blackberries all overgrowing their dump site. Because when they grow, right? They go everywhere. So like I say, it's getting tough to dump certain things. You know, if I filled up four of these things, or two big ones and a couple smaller ones, you know, it takes quite a bit of weight off. Cut up like this, so you could put, I don't know, 80 pounds in each container, 300-400 pounds, you could probably save. Name of the game, save money. See, I haven't done green waste very much. If I know it's $80, $100 dump, I wouldn't waste some time, right? But if it's like $150 dump, well, I can trim it down a little bit. Yeah, I'm just gonna keep going. I think we're gonna end the video here. I don't want to bore you guys too much, but wish my not sure what's wrong with that sod. I don't really like that design because you don't have no torque really. You know, you're just kind of flimsy. So I don't know why it's cutting lousy. So I threw a lot of crap at the back here. The better stuff to cut is further. If I can eliminate some of this heavier stuff, it will help reduce. Okay guys, I hope you enjoyed the video. You guys have a great day. Thanks for watching.